Right. I mean, they're just like you and me. You know, if we eat something that upsets our stomach, you know, we're not going to be very healthy. So it's the same concept at a very cellular level.
Angela Walsh is talking about the little creatures that are floating around inside the bottles next to her.
And we want to make sure that, you know, our operation's reliable, so we want to minimize that risk of them accidentally ingesting something they shouldn't.
You talk like they're little animals. I guess
they are. Yeah.
You want to keep them happy.
Exactly.
See it a little better.
You see those little dots floating around in there? Well, they're alive. They are colonies of cellular organisms.
The granules are.
And those larger black objects are a medium for the microorganisms to live on. And it turns out all of those cellular creatures are happily munching away on what they find in the wastewater that they're living in. Oh, you can tell they're happy because of the bubbles.
And they uptake the nutrients in our wastewater and they convert it to methane gas and CO2. So our wastewater is their food.
The wastewater comes from the Novozymes plant in Franklinton. The company produces enzymes for consumer, agricultural, and pharmaceutical products. Scientists monitor what's happening in the jars because it's a miniature version of what's happening in this.
We're spending money on something to treat our wastewater and then using the energy that it produces to run our plant.
This is the company's 237,000-gallon biogas reactor. It's tough to keep tabs on what's happening in there, so researchers duplicate the conditions in the lab.
Granular organisms live in the bottom third of the reactor. So the wastewater is pumped into the bottom, flows upwards, and there are two settler plates, one about halfway and one about three quarters, that separate the gas that's produced from the wastewater.
So the water, and then, so the water's just kind of circulating through this tank.
That's right.
And the little creatures are eating.
So the objective is to keep the organisms in the reactor, pass through the wastewater, and then as they generate the biogas, then the biogas is taken off the top.
The reactor is the first of its kind for a life sciences company in the region. The organisms in the tank process about 20 tons of organic material every day from the factory's wastewater system. The gas generated will be used to power the factory, along with the reactor. Looked at another way, that's enough gas to power 570 homes for a year.
So the gas off the top is then treated to remove hydrogen sulfide to make it safer. And then we compress that biogas, remove moisture from it, and then we use it in a boiler to make steam and hot water.
Until now, Novozymes wastewater has been treated in that. It's a 5 million gallon lagoon. It's an aerobic treatment system. The water is constantly bubbled and aerated so the microorganisms can process the waste. The new system will replace that. Just looking at it, you can see the tank is a lot smaller, obviously, but that's okay because an anaerobic treatment system is much more efficient and doesn't require all that aeration.
The water, though, isn't perfectly clean when it leaves the biogas plant. It is sent through a smaller aerobic treatment system before it is pumped to the county's wastewater treatment plant or used to irrigate nearby farms. And the biogas system is so carefully balanced that any change in what is being manufactured in the plant requires an adjustment in the biogas reactor, so the microorganisms aren't killed. But when the little creatures are happy, they are saving energy, water, and raw materials. And that's why all eyes are always watching those bottles.
So we're looking for the amount of gas that's produced. So that gives us an idea of how healthy the organisms are. The healthier they are, the more biogas that they're going to generate. And it also gives us an indication ahead of time of if there's something coming down the drain, if there's something in the wastewater that's making them sick. So it allows us to kind of test before it hits the full-scale installation for any obstacles or roadblocks.